Hey folks, so ever since I got an EV, I've been thinking, like a lot of people, about ways I can use it as a resource for providing backup power to my house in the case of an outage. Since most EVs have pretty large battery packs, like this one, a Chevy EUV has a 65 kilowatt hour battery pack, they can provide potentially days worth of power if you can figure out a way to access them. And I previously tried all the kind of typical ways of doing this, like attaching an inverter to the car battery and so forth, but all of them have different challenges, which I can talk about later. This is the first solution that I think actually meets my needs and will work great. And in fact, we've tested it for kind of a while, and spoiler alert, it did fantastic. So what this is the Ecoflow Alternator Charger. It's a new product that they just recently released, along with the Delta 2 power station. And I got these together as a package deal for about $800 on Amazon a few weeks ago. By itself, that's the alternator charger is like $600 MSRP. So generally, probably not worth it if you're going to pay full price, but it seems like Ecoflow is going to be doing some sales on them. So at that price point of $800 for both of them, that worked out pretty well for me. So thought I'd show everybody how this works. Also, there's a lot of videos about this product. Mostly sponsored. This is not a sponsored video, but I won't go into details about how to hook it up and all that kind of stuff necessarily, because I think there's a lot of videos about that. But every video I've seen is connecting this to a gas engine. So this is an EV, which is different animal. But I don't think this would be necessarily great for overlanding, which is the kind of, or van life or that kind of thing, or maybe even camping. Which I think is a more typical use for it. But as far as home backup, I think it works great. So the way this works is I have it connected with battery clamps, just as a temporary solution. So normally, if you were going to be doing this, especially for multiple days, you'd want to hardwire it to the car. It does come with ring terminals, but I got these heavy duty battery clamps just for testing. Because we also have a plug-in hybrid, which I want to try this with, and I haven't done that yet. So I wanted to be able to move it around easily. So I connected its positive and negative terminals. It's got this 6-gauge wire here. This is the charger here. As you can see, it's got a green light, meaning it's detecting any car power. Here's my Delta 2, which you can see is zero load right now, zero charging, about 94% battery. So it's all set up, and all I have to do is enable the charging, which you can do in the app. In this case, since I'm recording on my phone, I'm going to use this little on button right here. First, I'll show you that's no input at all, no output. And go ahead and turn it on. Got the green light here. And we should see it kick on and start ramping up the wattage. And there we go, right at 800, a little bit over actually, which is pretty much the max that this, the alternator charger will put out. And the way this works on an EV is rather than having an alternator, it has a DC to DC converter. DC to DC converter essentially takes the voltage from the battery, the traction battery, the one that actually moves the car, steps it down, which the traction battery is usually around 400 volts. It steps that down to 14 volts thereabouts in the case of this car, and then uses that to charge the 12 volt battery, which is used to power all the internal car lights and dash and all that kind of stuff. So this is the DC to DC converter right here. And in fact, it's actually actively cooled. So it's got a liquid cooling system right here. Probably can't hear it on the video, but it is running right now in order to put out that power. And that DC to DC converter is rated for, I've seen up to 130 amps. So at 14 volts, that's going to be somewhere around 1800 watts. So 800 watts is not really making a dent in that. There is obviously some internal electronics that are using some power, so you wouldn't want to go too much higher. Usually people with bolts say don't go over 1200, but obviously we're well under that. So it shouldn't be any too big of a deal. In fact, I can show you inside. I've got a voltmeter here. That even with that 800 watt draw, we're still at 14 volts for the 12 volt system. So really not taking any strain on the car at all. And in fact, you can see on the dash here in the right side there, it actually shows what the power draw for the car as a whole is, and it's showing as 1 kilowatt. And that's pretty much the minimum it shows. So even if I were to turn this off, it'll still show 1 kilowatt. So it just shows to show that 800 watts is not really making any big impact on the normal power usage of the car. So that's pretty much it. The next thing to do would be to show it actually powering my house. So I've got this plugged into a heavy duty extension cable now, which runs over here to my generator inlet. That blue adapter there on the ground is a bridged adapter that goes to the 50 amp generator inlet that I have. So essentially it'll power both legs of the circuit breaker panel with the same 120 volt leg from the Ecoflow. So that won't work for 240 volt devices, but it'll work fine for 120 volt devices. And that's the majority of what we have. So I'll go ahead and turn on the AC inverter and we can see the load coming out. So you can see you got an initial peak there. Now it's dropping down. And the reason that the Ecoflow is nice specifically is because it hits this 800 watts, which we have a sense energy monitor here. And so I know that our average usage throughout the day is usually 600 to 800 watts at any given time. Like if you average out our total kilowatt hour usage over the course of the day. So the Ecoflow basically can handle the surges, right? So this in the case is a Delta 2. So it can handle 1800 watts continuous and up to 2700 surge. And it kind of evens things out. And then the car just provides that ongoing 800 watts to just kind of continuously recharge the battery. So we've run this for already 6 hours, no trouble. Could really probably go for several days because with the 65 kilowatt hours in the battery of the car, you know, if we're being conservative with our power, we could keep it down around like 10 or 12 kilowatts a day. And that's, you know, that's 6 days. And that's not even counting solar, which we do have some solar panels for the Ecoflow to connect and charge it there. The only real issue is with this Delta 2. It doesn't, the surge is not great. And the continuous is a little bit low at 1800 watts. It works okay for us for most things. We just have to be careful about doing things like running a microwave at the same time as, you know, something else. Or it doesn't start our gas dryer because the inflow is too high. But I think like a Delta Max, the Delta 2 Max would be pretty good. That was just out of my price range. So Delta 2 is what we got. And the last bit I think I'll show is, and I've never tried this, is to actually plug in the solar, which I got some solar panels up on the roof over here, and see if that will charge at the same time. So if we can actually get over that 800 by adding solar in. And there we go. So it's actually adding solar on top of it. It's a little bit overcast right now, so not a lot. We're getting about 100 watts out of those 400 watt panels, 400 watts of panels. But yeah, so there's a lot of folks that have talked about there's an alternator charger from Pecron that will do up to 500 watts. Costs about $150, and it plugs into, you know, whatever solar input you have on your power station. So it's vendor agnostic. And the cool thing here is you could actually use them both, I think, and get up to 1300 watts if your car will support it, which I think this one pretty much would. And if 13 was a little high, you can actually adjust in the app for Ecoflow. You can adjust it a little bit lower, so you could get it down to 1000 or 1200 or whatever you wanted. So you could actually stack them. I haven't tried that, but I bet it would work. Also people say, you know, oh, the Pecron's so much cheaper, but you know, with this deal, I mean, I think that this was probably about the same price. And, on top of that, it integrates with the app. I can control it remotely. The Pecron, you have to manually adjust, and so forth. So this seemed like a much better deal to me. And I've also tested out, you can set the minimum voltage threshold, and on this one it's 13 volts right now, and if I turn my car off, it'll immediately turn off. So it's only gonna run when the car is actually actively powered on. And there's tricks to keep the bolt on indefinitely, which there's a million videos about that. So, and the last bit I'll mention is in the manual. It actually has a section about using the XT60 charging mode from the alternator charger, which to me tells me that they're planning on releasing a generic cable that would go to, you know, an XT60 on other EcoFlow power stations, but you could then adapt that to the solar input at any power station and use this in a more generic fashion, just like that PECRON. So I think that's probably something on the way based on them printing that out of the manual. I did mention at the beginning, I tried a lot of other ways of doing this, and none of them really worked. So for instance, connecting an inverter to the car, I tried that. Issue with that is the surge is not great. You know, this car can really only handle, like I mentioned, you know, 1200 watts or so continuous. If I tried surges, what happened was the voltage of the 12 volt battery would drop too low, and that actually disabled the car. When it went below 12 volts, the car threw a fault, wouldn't let me shift into gear. I had to do a hard reset of the car just to get it to drive again. So that wasn't great. And then just using more of a generic like DC to DC converter, which there's also videos on that. You can buy one off Amazon, like a dumb DC to DC converter that steps up 12 volts to 24, 36, 48, whatever. And then get some adapters to plug that into your solar input, kind of DIY this solution. The problem with that is those DC to DC converters are dumb. There's no app, you know, connectivity to them. They may not allow you to set a minimum voltage threshold. So when your car's off, they may keep draining the battery. They get pretty hot, so there's that too. And you know, it ends up being about the same price. When you put all that together, you're spending at least a couple hundred dollars on the converter plus cabling and everything. So if you get a package deal like I did, this just seems like a no-brainer. All right, thanks a lot.